Hi everybody, welcome back to Stamping School. I've got some fun snail mail for you today, and I want to show you how to do this little blending work right here with the markers and how to get that texture in there. So this is from Snail Mail, which is in the Stampin' Up mini catalog, January through June, and you'll find everything on page 54. I'll go through it quickly so you can see. So here are the dies, 13 of the dies and 8 of the stamp set. And the dies will cut out these snails right here and the mushrooms. There's also this postage stamp 2 by 2 1/8 inch die right here, which is kind of nice to have. And then this little mini envelope and a little letter. So if you want to send off a little, give someone a little letter on a card or something, that's really cute. And this will fit inside there. And then there's this little quote, and that'll fit the hello in there. And then this guy, the You've Got Mail, that's fun for an envelope. Also, this Happy Mail enclosed is great for an envelope. So I like that, that's kind of fun. And then one of the dies cuts out this one right here. And I have 2 stamps here, but really there's just 1 heart stamp, but they gave us 2 dies. So it's nice. You can stamp a few of them and cut them both out at the same time. So that's the bundle. And then also in the suite, there's these resin hearts, and they're little tiny red and white hearts. And I put a couple of rhinestones on here just so you could kind of see the size comparison. If you have our rhinestones, they're about the same height and width as the medium rhinestones. So they mail fine. I still put a piece of cardstock or a piece of little piece of paper towel over the top of a card when I'm mailing something bumpy like this. But they're nice and thin. Like I said, about the same height and size as the medium rhinestone. And there's twine. There's a little bundle, a 2-pack of Blushing Bride in white twine. And then the designer paper, which is really fun. If you get the bundle with the dies, you might as well get the paper too, because this die will cut out that little guy right there. And then this is the back side, little pink and red scribbles. These little borders, which I love these because you can actually just cut them out like this and use them as strips on cards or accents, things like that. Little stitches on the other side. Big mushrooms, which these dies do not cut out any mushrooms. I kind of wish they did, but they coordinate, obviously. Little red and pink hearts on that side. This one, this sweet thing here with the presents on her shell, that die will cut that out. And this die will cut out the little envelopes right there. Little snail trails on the back. And then more borders, you know, if you want to just print out these, or if you want to fussy cut out the little presents, you could. Postage stamps on that side. Mushrooms and mushrooms. And in all kinds of languages, the little quotes, you can say hello, bonjour. You can say hello in any language you want here, or you can just use one of these cute little hearts. That's the paper. Now also on this card, I'm using those little whimsy dies. So I had a request from Michael to show these whimsy dies, because in the catalog, it's really hard to see. They're down here, stitched with whimsy dies. And the way that they're cut out like that, it looks like they cut out that and then they stitch, but they're open-ended. So I'll show you what those look like. Page 72, stitched with whimsy dies. There's no bundle for them, they're just on their own. So they look like this. They're kind of all curvy and wavy. So the largest one will go on a 4 1/4 by 5 1/2 card. And so you trim around it. This can be as big as you want, and you just trim the card to fit. So this is the size for the largest one. The next size down, which we're gonna use, is the 3 1/2 by 4 3/4. But again, you can make that paper any size, but that's the size that that fits nicely. And then we've got 2 3/4, 2 inches, and then this rectangle, 1 1/2 by 2 3/4, and this little guy is 1 1/4. I really like the rectangle because I think that's going to be very useful for things to highlight different greetings without feeling like you have to layer everything. But when the first time I saw these, I immediately thought of snail trails. And I wanted them to use with these trails. It looks like they, you know, they kind of traveled all around and then they kind of met up right here in the middle. Okay. Now I have this layered on a little skinny bit of red, and I want to do just a little bit of shading back there. We're going to use some balmy blue and one of the brushes, and you tap a little bit on and then always take a little off just because you don't want it to be too heavy, and just give it a little glow right where they're going to be sitting. Just a little bit to take up the starkness on the white. I don't even know if this is going to pick up on camera, but it's there. And then we're going to take a little bit of the ink that's in here. Squeeze the back of the pad, and we're going to take my aqua painter. If you don't have that, you can just use a wet paintbrush. But pick a little bit of that ink up and, oops, get out of the way, everybody. And just do a little splattering, just to sort of give it a little bit of life in there. Put that aside to dry. All right, let's bring these guys in. And I have a ton of blends. These are the alcohol markers. So to do this texture that we want to do, see how the snail has all that texture on him? I've showed this before, but just in case you might be new here and you've missed it. And I will confess that on this one, I cut out these little pieces right here. But this time, let's just try to add a little bit of blue on there and see if I can make that disappear. I feel like it should be just a little bit tighter, but I'm going to try it and see how it looks. Just by giving it a little bit of blue in there, it might disappear. It wasn't hard to go in with the scissors to just kind of finish cutting that little bit out. See right there and right there? But I'm picky. I'm going to just color this heart quickly with, I'm using dark real red. By the way, it's interesting to note that the die that cuts out this little guy right here does not cut out the words, so it cuts it out. So I might just unmount that. I might trim that right off the stamp and put that out separate anyway. That way I can use it for other things. And then this still cuts out the snail. All right, I'm using light gray granite for this snail slug little guy. And I'm just doing a real quick scribble in little circles. It's okay to leave a little bit of white in there. That's the base. I'm coming in with my dark gray granite, and the smoky slate would work fine, whatever color you want. This one's going to be pink, so whatever. And using the bullet tip right here, we're going to dot and we're going to add texture this way, and then we're going to take off some. So I'm doing little dots, little specks, little freckles. Could they be called freckles? Possibly. Just like this. And remember, when it dries, it's lighter. It's kind of like paint. You know, it goes on and then lightens as it dries. Okay, so there's some speckles. Then we're going to go in with the color lifter. That's the clear one. It's sold individually. It's called the color lifter, and it'll actually remove some color. So I'm going to let that dry just a minute before I go in, because it can be too much alcohol on the paper all at once and it might blur. So let's hold on this one. Let's go to this snail over here. I'm doing dark petal pink. And again, with my scribbles, just scribbling on the color carefully here around his eyes. Coming in with light calypso coral. The same dots. Dot, 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 dot. And you don't want to do a lot of pressure, obviously. You want to keep your bullet tip nice and sharp. There we go. I'm going to bring that color down a little here. Sort of a great flamingo color. And then for his shell, and I'll show you how to get that texture also, we are using light Night of Navy. I just wanted a nice, strong color blue. Stay in your lines. That's why I really love the bullet tip better, to stay in those lines. When you scribble like that, you're going to give it a little bit of texture anyway. All right, let's go back to this guy. Color lifter has the same thing. It's got a brush tip on one side and the bullet tip on the other. On the bullet tip side, you're going to make little dots, and you're kind of more than just dotting like we did originally, you're going to kind of scoot it a little bit and let it sit there a minute. And when you do that, you're going to get great texture. I think I showed this on an alligator a long time ago, but let me see if we can get a little closer. Can you see that texture on there? Pardon my Band-Aid. It's really cool, and it looks really great with darker colors. Let me show you. Now, the darker it is, do less dots until you kind of get to what you want. It's starting to happen, and it's going to take a few seconds behind. Okay, and you're going to sit there and watch it for a second, leave it alone, and then go back and look at it and see if it's enough. Because, you know, this one is a little too much. I mean, maybe it's okay, but it's a little too much. Now we're going to do dark Just Jade over on this present here. And believe it or not, we're going to do coral on his stripes. Whoops, went outside the line a little. And then soft seafoam. And this is the light. We're just going to add a little bit here and there, do some scribbling. Then I'll see if I can go back and fix that little blur right there. All right. So there's the light. And we need a little bit of dark. So we're just going to do some flicking. Flick, 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 flick. See if I can kind of, there we go. Get rid of those little lines. It's just enough to just give it a little bit of a difference. Now, when something like this is colored and it's too solid for you, you can use the color lifter once it's dry. And you know it's dry because it's not cool anymore. It'll be real cold to the touch when it's not dry because it's alcohol. So we're going to take the blender, the color lifter, and I'm just going to flick this up. Hear it? And I'm adding little stripes in there, and it just gives a little bit of texture. And this just disappears. I mean, you don't have to clean it off or anything. It just stays clear. Now we can bring all this back in, settle the snail right on those little snail trails. This one's coming in with a present. This one's coming in with a gift card. This little, they really need like a little happy birthday. I'll look around to see what fits in there for happy birthday. I just thought the little heart was cute to put right here, just to add a little bit of color. So my red is repeated 3 times, and I'm gonna just put this right here. Ooh, I forgot the ribbon. So just to balance out that green over here, I had added a little tiny bit of jade ribbon to kind of balance out that, but it doesn't really need it. It's kind of cute the way it is. And then on the inside, I left it blank so I can write something, since it's just a hello card, kind of. It might be a birthday. I'm not sure what I'm going to do with it yet, but I just cut out those mushrooms and put a little bit of red cardstock to kind of ground it down there. So that's how you get your snails to have that fun texture. All right. Thanks for watching, everybody. We'll see you next time. See it, learn it, stamp it.